He's playing with his duck. So, it's actually a good question, because there's so many offers that everybody gets bombarded with.
Want to buy a duck?
Can you buy followers? Could they be ducks? No.
Could you?
Can you buy ducks as followers?
He'll follow you for a fee.
Again, it might be a short-term gain, but it will be long-term pain. And the reason for that is that Google and Twitter and Facebook and all of these platforms constantly, and this is even years later, are culling through their supposed subscribers and accounts that are on the system, and they recognize the ones that are bots. And what I mean by that is they're not real people. And so, generally speaking, when you pay for followers or subscribers or whatever, you're buying it from people who use automated computers, bots, to go in and automatically follow you. Then they set up fake profiles and fake pictures and fake posts. It's very elaborate.
Many of them are actually real people. Not to belittle the fact that there are bots, but there are a lot of people who do this with people in third world countries, with people who are at home income kind of people in third world countries typically, where they'll literally rally 10,000 people to go and click on things for you and create comments on pages. But as David said, it's obvious that they're not real users. And that alone is enough for Google or for Instagram or Facebook or LinkedIn to basically discredit that value. And does that discredit follow to your account? Some say yes, some say no. I don't think anybody's ever been able to really do good solid math on that.
I think there's a balance.
But I think there's probably a negative impact.
Yeah.
And most certainly, and I think this is really prevalent on Instagram, you can tell when you visit an Instagram that's got a bunch of bogus followers. You can tell. You look at it and it just doesn't add up. Follows 3. 22,000 followers, 11 comments. Like, it doesn't add up. The math is wrong, and it's obvious that it's fake. Is that the perspective you want to share with those people that are coming to your profile? Is there value to being genuine and saying, yeah, we have 700 followers and we're happy about it, as opposed to 10,000 where they're all fake?
Yeah. The other thing is, what are you telling Google in the world when 10,000 of your recent likes came from Singapore or Taiwan or the Philippines? Pick a country.
That's a good point. That's a really good
point.
And
your marketing, your services, and your followers, your people, your clients are in the US or in Canada or in Europe.
Northern Alberta, yeah. Selling oil field supplies.
What are you telling people?
27,000 likes are from Indonesia and South Asia.
And yes, they know that.
Yeah, they can tell. So, it's obvious to the systems at work that it's fake. Does that help you? In a lot of ways, I don't understand how it would.
So devil's advocate on that. I think there is, for some people, especially people who are starting out their businesses, there's a balance. And I'm not talking extreme 10,000 or 100,000 followers or likes or whatever. But let's say they got 100, that it helps them optically look better than something that has 2 likes or 3 people who followed it or whatever. And they feel better and they feel reassured that somebody else looking at that piece of content is going to give it a little bit more value or increase the trust. Now we're arguing on whether or not you want the platform to recognize legitimate content and give it its value to show up potentially on hashtags that are trending, and so that you could get some more exposure out of it, or whether you want to hurt yourself right off the bat by optically inflating those numbers and paying the price.
Yeah, I think there are different ways to approach it. If you're going to pay for that kind of attention, you can. There's nobody saying don't do it. But understand sort of the scale, right? If you're a new creator, spending, $10 to get 150 likes or 500 likes or watches on a video, maybe that's not a terrible spend. But if you try to do 10,000 out of the gate, it's going to be obvious.
And you have three subscribers.
And you have three subscribers. So, you know, you kind of have to, you know, it's all about balance. I mean, David said it. It's all about balance.
So on the flip side, if you did want a strategy that might work for you is to join a group of peers where you like and follow and comment on each other's videos and social media posts and whatever and share them out to increase the exposure. And it's sort of a back scratching system, and it won't be big numbers, but it helps out.
Yeah.
In fact, a lot of YouTubers, if we look at where they were and where they're at now, it's because they got mentioned or a shout out or whatever, some appropriate from somebody else's channel who happens to have a bunch of followers or subscribers.
Yeah, there are a lot of, most major communities have a YouTuber group on Facebook or something like that. It's a great opportunity to join. You'll get 50 or 100 people to see your content that maybe would never get found on its own. Similarly, you know, LinkedIn business groups are a great place to share your expertise and share links to content that will get views that way. So there are other ways to do it, separate from simply putting a tenner on the table and expecting somebody to get 500 people to come and visit.
Thanks for watching!
If you like the content you see on our channel, hit the subscribe button. And if you really like it, hit the bell so you can be notified when new videos get released. If you like it, give us a thumbs up. If you don't like it, give us two thumbs down. We're serious about this. We really, really appreciate your feedback.